भद्रं विष्णु शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिनी व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहना भवतु सहनो भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः
श्लोक 73 तद्बुद्धयस्तदात्मानः तन्निष्ठास्तत्परायणाः गच्छन्त्यपुनरावृत्तिम् ज्ञाननिर्धूतकल्मषाः विद्याविनयसम्पन्ने ब्राह्मणे गविहस्तिनि शुनिचैवश्वपाके च पंडिता समदर्शिनः The vision of a jnani, a pandita. Pandita means a jnani. Panda, atma vishaya buddhihi. Asya sanjata iti panditaha. Panda plus itachya pratyaya becomes a panditaha. Panda means Atmajnana. Panda asya sanjata iti pandita. A jnani. His vision. He sees Brahman in and through everything. In the Nama Rupa, there are differences. The differences are very much there in the world. Caused by Nama Rupa. In and through the Nama Rupa, he sees, he is aware of the same Brahman. Here, this verse can be a very good answer to a question. Whether a jnani sees Brahman in and through the world, or does he not see the world at all? He sees only Brahman. He is not even experiencing the world. There are some people they think Brahman is experienced in a distinct mystical state. A Brahmajnani cannot be aware of the world. Some people think so. This shloka is a very good answer to that. A jnani is aware of the world. He continues to see various people, various objects. But in and through the universe, he is aware of the presence of Brahman, in which there is no difference. Vidya vinaya sampanni brahmani. A brahmana who is endowed with the vidya and vinaya, learning and humility. Brahmana with vidya and vinaya is a sattvika person. Gavi hastini, then there are cows. So cow stands for rajasika. So gavi, domestic animals, rajasika. Then hastini, shuni chaiva shvapake cha. Hastini, hasti means elephant. Shuni, dog, in dog, all these are in saptami vibhakti. Shvanna shabda. Saptami ekavachanam becomes shuni. Chaiva shvapakecha. Shvapaka means one who cooks dog meat. The human being who eats a dog is called shvapaka. Means a lowly human being without much culture. That kind of human being. Panditas samadarshinaha. Panditaha. The jnanis are samadarshinaha. They see the samam everywhere. They see the Brahman in everything. See the Bhashya. ये शाम जानेना नाशितमात्मनः अज्ञानम् ते पंडिताः कथं तत्त्वं पश्यन्ति इति उच्यते येषां आत्मनः अज्ञानं जानेन नाशितम्। Whose ignorance of Atma is destroyed by Jnana. Te panditaha, such panditaha. Katham tattvam pasyanti. How do they see the truth? How are they aware of the truth? Iti uchyate. It is being told in this shloka. विद्या विनय संपन्ने विद्या च विनयश्च विद्या विनयो विनयः उपशमः इट्स नॉट देयर
विद्या आत्मनः बोधः
This reading is not there everywhere. Even without that, it's true. So, Vidya Atmanaha Bodha. विनयः उपशमः
विनयः उपशमः
ताभ्यां
ताभ्यां
विद्याविनयाभ्यां
विद्याविनयाभ्यां
सम्पन्नः
सम्पन्नः
विद्याविनयसम्पन्नः
विद्याविनयसम्पन्नः
विद्वान्
विद्वान्
विनीतश्चयो ब्राह्मणः
विनीतश्चयो ब्राह्मणः
तस्मिन् ब्राह्मणे
तस्मिन् ब्राह्मणे
गवी
गवी
हस्तिनी
हस्तिनी
शुनिचैव
शुनिचैव
श्वपाकेच
श्वपाकेच
पण्डिताः समदर्शिनः
पण्डिताः समदर्शिनः
विद्या विनय संपन्ने विग्रह वाक्य विद्या च विनयश्च विद्या विनयौ ताभ्यां संपन्नः विद्या विनय संपन्नः सो वन हु इज एंडोर्ड विद विद्या एंड विनय वन हु इज रिच विद विद्या एंड विनय इज कॉल्ड विद्या विनय संपन्नः And he gives the meaning of Vidya and Vinaya. Vidya means Atmanaha Bodhaha, knowledge of the Atma. It can be Atmanaha Bodhaha, knowledge of the Atma, or it can be any other knowledge also. Shankaracharya takes it to refer to Atmanaha Bodhaha, knowledge of the Atma, Atma Jnana. Vinayaha Upashamaha. Vinaya means humility, upashamaha. Tabhyam vidya vinaya abhyam sampannaha vidya vinaya sampannaha. Vidvan vinitaschayo brahmana. So vidya vinaya sampannaha brahmanaha means the brahmana who is vidvan and vinita. He is learned as well as humble. Tasmin Brahmane, that kind of Brahmana, in that kind of Brahmana. And Gavi, in cow, Hastini, in elephant, Shunichaiva, in dog, also in dog, Shvapakecha, in A dog meat eater. Panditas samadarshinaha. Panditaha jnaninaha. They are samadarshinaha. Samam drashtum shilam yesham te samadarshinaha. They always see samam. विद्या विनय संपन्ने
विद्या विनय संपन्ने
उत्तम संस्कारवती
उत्तम संस्कारवती
ब्राह्मणे
ब्राह्मणे
सात्विके
सात्विके
मध्यमायांच
मध्यमायांच
राजस्याम
राजस्याम
गवी
गवी
संस्कारहीनायां
संस्कारहीनायां
अत्यन्तमेव
अत्यन्तमेव
केवलतामसे
केवलतामसे
अस्त्यादौ च
अस्त्यादौ च
सत्त्वादिगुणैः
सत्त्वादिगुणैः
तज्जैश्च संस्कारैः
तज्जैश्च संस्कारैः
तथा राजसैः
तथा राजसैः
तथा तामसैश्च संस्कारैः
तथा तामसैश्च संस्कारैः
अत्यन्तमेव अस्पृष्टम्
अत्यन्तमेव अस्पृष्टम्
समम्
समम्
एकम्
एकम्
अविक्रियं ब्रह्मा
अविक्रियं ब्रह्मा
द्रष्टुं शीलं
द्रष्टुं शीलं
येषांते
येषांते
पंडिताः
पंडिताः
समदर्शिनः
समदर्शिनः
विद्या विनय संपन्ने उत्तम संस्कारवति ब्राह्मणी विद्या विनय संपन्न ब्राह्मण इस उत्तम संस्कारवान ब्राह्मण ए पर्सन हू हैज ग्रेट संस्कारा बेस्ट संस्कारा एंड ही इज सात्विका एंड देन मध्यमायांच मीडियोकर मीडियोकर वन इज द कौ कौ स्टैंड्स फॉर द मीडियोकर because it is rajasyam it is rajasi he takes the gauhu as a streelinga therefore he says rajasyam rajasi it is rajasi in nature and it is samskarahina it does not have uttama samskara it is samskarahina शास्त्रीय संस्कार हीन एंड देन देयर इज इवन लोवर अत्यंतमेव केमलता केवलतामसे हस्त्यादौ च अत्यंतमेव तामसे केवलतामसे अत्यंतमेव अधमे अत्यंतमेव यू कैन सप्लाई अधमे वेरी लोली एंड वाई इट इज लोली केवल तामसे टोटल तमस टोटल तामसिका सी गौहु एटसेट्रा है सम तमस बट देर इज रजस ऑल्सो एंड सम सत्वा ऑल्सो But here in Hasti etc., it is Kevala Tamasa. Means most predominantly Tamasa. It's not that they don't have Rajas and Sattva. They will have a little Rajas and Sattva also. But predominantly Tamasa. To such an extent that Rajas and Sattva are as good as Nindra. Therefore he says kevala tamasi hastyadauca sattvadi gunaihi gunaihi tajjaischa samskaraihi so in all these animals in all these beings there is one brahman there is the same brahman And the Brahman is not affected by the guna which is present in these beings. Sattvadi gunaihi, the guna starting with the sattva, etc. The Atma is not affected by the three gunas. Brahman is not affected by the three gunas. Though it is equally present in all the three, it is not affected by sattva adi gunas. And tajjaischa samskaraihi, tajjaihi means sattva guna jaihi samskaraihi, means sattvikaihi samskaraihi. It is not affected by sattvika samskara. Tatha rajasaihi. Also, it is not affected by Rajasa Samskara, Tatha Tamasaischa Samskarihi. Likewise, it is not affected by Tamasa Samskara also. Atyantameva Asprishtam. So, Sattvadi Gunaihi, Tajjaihi Samskarihi, Tatha Rajasaihi, Tatha Tamasaihi Samskarihi. Atyantameva Asprishtam. It is absolutely untouched, unaffected, samam. Samam means ekam avikriyam brahma. So samam means, samam involves two things. One is ekam. Ekam means without divisions, without distinction. The same Brahman is present in everything. without any differences, without any divisions, and avikriyam, without any modifications. Brahma, that kind of Brahman, drashtum shilam yesham te samadarshinaha, those who see, those who are aware of the Brahman, which is samam in all the beings, such people are samadarshinaha. Sloka 19. Ihai vatairjitas sargaha.
Ihai vatairjitas sargaha.
Yesham samye sthitam manaha.
Yesham samye sthitam manaha.
Nirdosham hi samam brahma.
Nirdosham hi samam brahma.
Tasmad brahmani te sthitaha.
Tasmad brahmani te sthitaha.
So now, brahmajnana phala is being told. Yesham manaha samye sthitam. Whose mind abides in the samya. Samya literally means sameness. And here we should understand sameness means Brahma. Brahman is called Samya because in Brahman there are no differences. So Samye Brahmani sthitam, their mind abides. Taihi iha eva sargaha jitaha. Taihi, by such jnanis, iha eva, iha means in this world itself, means while being alive. Sargaha jitaha, they have conquered sarga. Sarga means srishti, janma, birth, meaning samsara. They have conquered samsara. They are free from samsara even while being alive. So the next line justifies this statement. How the Brahmajnani can be free from samsara while being alive? Because a Brahmajnani also lives in the body only, just like any Ajnani. When he is living in the body, like any other ajnani, how can he be free from samsara? So then the answer is given, nirdosham hi samam brahma. Brahman is samam. Brahman is sama. Sama means same. Same means free from differences. Since Brahman is samam, Brahman is nirdosham. Samatvat nirdosham. Free from all doshas. That which is free from differences is free from dosha. Because when something has differences, that means it is limited. and limitation is the dosha. When Brahman is samam, there is no limitation in Brahman. Since there is no limitation, Brahman is free from dosha. So samatvat nirdosham. So samam brahma nirdosham hi. So he means yasmat. Yasmat samam brahma nirdosham. Tasmat, therefore, te brahmanisthitaha, te jnaninaha, those who are aware of the Brahman, which is free from dosha, te brahmani eva sthitaha, we have to include an eva, they abide only in Brahman. Even though they seem to be present in the body, they are not really standing in the body. They are present in their own nature, Brahman, which is free from dosha, which is free from samsara. Therefore, the first line stands justified. The knower of Brahman has conquered samsara. Nanu abhojyanaha
abhojyanaha
te doshavantaha
te doshavantaha
sama samabhyam
sama samabhyam
vishamasami
vishamasami
pujataha
pujataha
iti smritehe
iti smritehe.
Connecting this shloka with the previous shloka, Shankaracharya raises an objection. Panditas samadarshinaha, jnanis see the same everywhere. See, Panditas samadarshinaha, while translating this we should be careful. So Panditas samadarshinaha does not mean they see everything as same. Seeing everything as same, it is not Brahmajna. It is myopia. If I have myopia, this eye has myopia. If I see people with this eye, everyone will look same for. So he will see the differences. The jnani will be aware of the differences. But in the meantime, he knows that in and through all the names and forms, in and through all the different names and forms, the same Brahman pervades. And the same Brahman alone is the absolute reality. The differences are only mithya. They are not the absolute. He is aware of this. Therefore, we should be careful in understanding these statements. It is not equality without quality. Nowadays people talk about equality, but the equality is without quality. A gross understanding of equality. So, having heard the previous shloka, Pandita Samadarshinaha, this person can get a doubt. And the doubt is based on a Dharma Sutra. Dharma Sutra are written by certain rishis based on the Vedas, based on the Karma Kanda portion of the Vedas. It's a part of Dharma Shastra. So in Dharma Shastra, there is a prescription of how you have to treat the other people. This person is inviting some learned brahmanas to his house and he is doing puja to them, he is honoring them. Now there are various brahmanas, various people. Some people have learnt one Veda, some people have learnt two Vedas, Dvivedi, and somebody is Trivedi, and somebody is Chaturvedi, somebody has studied Veda as well as Shadanga, Shadangavita. So there are people with different levels of learning. And somebody has learnt only Gayatri Mantra. So there can be different type of people. Now, Shastra says, you have to treat them differently. When you give Dakshina, or when you honor them, first you have to honor one who has learnt the highest. If there is a Chaturvedi, not the name Chaturvedi, real Chaturvedi. If he is a real Chaturvedi, then he should be honored first. And the greatest amount of Dakshina should be given to him. So when there are people with a different qualification, they should be treated in accordance with their qualification. Instead, if someone treats them equally, everyone is treated equally, then he will get Pratyavaya. All of them cannot be treated equal. One has to make distinction based on their qualification. One who deserves higher honor should be honored, should be given the higher honor. Likewise, there are people with the same qualification. It is another occasion. There are people with the same qualification. All have learnt one Veda. Then you cannot distinguish them. You cannot say, I will treat him better, I will not treat him the same way. You cannot see. So, if you do that, you will get Pratyavaya. If they have the same qualification, they should be treated equally. That is told by Gautama Dharma Sutra. Samasamabhyam Vishamasame Pujataha. Samasamabhyam Vishamasame Pujataha. I will read the Anandagiri Vyakhyana on this, explaining this sutra. Samanam Vishame Pratipatti Visheshe Kriyamane Sati. So they are Sama. Sama means they have equal qualification. Adhyayanadibhis Samana Dharmakanam. In terms of Adhyayana, etc. In terms of learning, etc. Learning or position, whatever. In terms of Adhyayana, etc. They have Samana Dharma. They are equal in their qualities. Then, Vastralankaradi Pujaya Vishame Pratipatti Visheshe Kriyamane Sati. If they are treated unequally, Vishame Pratipatti Visheshe Kriyamane Sati. If they are treated unequally while doing Vastralankaradi Puja, while giving shawl, etc., we do Vastralankara. So you put a bigger shawl to one person and a small shawl to another person. So if they are honored differently, and asamana dharmakanam, if they don't have the equal qualification, someone is less qualified and more qualified, then, so how asamana dharmakanam, Anandagiri explains, kasyachit eka vedatvam, somebody has learnt only one Veda, aparasya dvivedatvam, ityadi dharmavatam, another person has studied two Vedas, ityadi. In this manner, they have asamana dharma. Praguptaya pujaya same pratipatti visheshe. If they are treated equally, same shawl is given to all. Then, pujayita purusha vishesham jnatva pratipattim akurvan. The pujayita, one who does the puja, one who honors them, purusha vishesham jnatva pratipattim akurvan. Since he has not understood their qualification, he has not made effort to understand their qualification properly. Therefore, dhana dharma cha hiyate. So he gets a papa. And dhana dharma cha hiyate. He loses dharma, punya, and he loses money also with that. So it is told in the Shastra. So tena sattvike rajasa kamasayoscha samabuddhim kurvan pratyavaiti ityarthah. Similarly, Purvapakshi says, one who treats sattvika, rajasa, tamasa people as equal, he will get pratyavad according to Dharma Shastra. He will treat a brahmana also equally, and he will treat a dog also equally. Then he will get pratyavad. So, Purvapakshi says, te doshavantaha, the panditaha, who are samadarshinaha, they are doshavantaha, according to Gautama Dharma Sutra. Iti smatehe samasamabhyam vishamasame pujataha iti smatehe te doshavantaha. So, based on this smati, they are doshavantaha. They have dosha. They are papis. Dosha means papa. And therefore, they become abhojyanaha. Certain papa makes you unqualified for giving bhiksha. You cannot give bhiksha if you have done this. The people will not accept your anna. Abhojyanaha. So the smriti says certain people, they are abhojyanaha. Because of certain types of papa they have committed. One should not eat their food. One should avoid eating in their house. So such people are called abhojyanaha. Abhojyam annam yesham te abhojyanaha. Bahuvrihi samasa. The people whose food is abhojya. So abhojyanaha indicates great pap, not an ordinary pap. So Purapakshi attributes the same dosha to this pandita. Then Siddhanti says, नते दोषवन्तः
नते दोषवन्तः
कथम्
कथम्
इहैव
इहैव
जीवत्भिरेव
जीवत्भिरेव
तैः
तैः
समदर्शिभिः
समदर्शिभिः
पण्डितैः
पण्डितैः
जितः
जितः
वशीकृतः
वशीकृतः
सर्गः
सर्गः
जन्म
जन्म
येषां
येषां
साम्ये
साम्ये
सर्वभूतेषु ब्रह्मणि समभावे
सर्वभूतेषु ब्रह्मणि समभावे
स्थितं
स्थितं
निश्चलीभूतं
निश्चलीभूतं
मनः
मनः
अन्तःकरणं
अन्तःकरणं
नते दोषवन्तः. Siddhanti says, they don't have dosha. Your allegation of dosha is not proper when it comes to a jnani. Tena doshavantaha katham, how they are free from dosha? Because they are free from all doshas of samsara. Being jnanis. Ihaiva. Ihaiva means jivatbhireva. While being alive. Jivatbhihi eva. Jivat shatra. Jivat is shatranta. Tratiya bahuvachan. Jivatbhihi taihi eva. Taihi jivatbhihi eva. While being alive, jivatbhihi qualifies taihi. Taihi is tritiya. Therefore, jivatbhihi is tritiya. It is kartari tritiya. Because taihi sargaha jitaha. Sarga is jita by them. Kartari tritiya. Jita is karmani prayoga. So, karmani prayoga, the karta is in tritiya. Taihi samadarshibhihi, panditaihi. Taihi refers to the panditas who are samadarshinaha. Jitaha means vashikrataha, conquered. Sargaha means janma. Janma means samsa. By who? येषां साम्ये स्थितं मनः हूस् मनः अबाइड्स इन द साम्य. साम्य मीन्स समभावे. साम्ये इज इक्वल टू समभावे. समभाव सेमनेस. सर्वभूतेषु सर्वभूतेषु साम्ये. Sameness in all beings. So all beings don't have sameness because beings are different. Then if your mind has to abide in the sameness in all beings, then where it should abide? It should abide in Brahman. Therefore, Samabhavi implies Brahmani. Brahmani sthitam. So, Sarvabhuteshu Samabhavi is equal to Brahmani. By implication, it means Brahmani. Sthitam. Sthitam means nishchali bhutam. Becomes steady. Is steady, has become steady. Nishchali bhutam. Manaha means antahkaranam. The mind has become steady in the Brahman. Nirdosham.
Nirdosham.
No, he takes nirdosham. So nirdosham hi samam brahma. He takes that line. Yadyapi.
Yadyapi.
Doshavatsu.
Doshavatsu.
Swapakadishu.
Swapakadishu.
Moodhaihi.
Moodhaihi.
Taddoshaihi.
Taddoshaihi.
Doshavadiva.
Doshavadiva.
Vibhavyate.
Vibhavyate.
Tathapi.
Tathapi.
Taddoshaihi.
Taddoshaihi.
Asamsprishtam. Asamsprishtam.
Asamsprishtam.
Asprishtam. Okay, so asprishtam or asamsprishtam. Both are correct. Asprishtam.
Asprishtam.
Iti.
Iti.
Nirdosham.
Nirdosham.
Doshavarjitam.
Doshavarjitam.
Hi yasmat.
Hi yasmat.
So he means yasmat. The following line is hetu. Hetu for their being free from samsara. He yasmat nirdosham. Since Brahman is nirdosha, yadyapi, even though, doshavatsu swapakadishu, Brahman is there in all that has dosha. Swapaka, swapakadi, swapaka, etc. They have dosha. Doshavatsu. And the Brahman pervades all of them. Brahman pervades all that has dosha. Then an ajnani will think that the Brahman is affected by those doshas. Moodhaihi taddoshaihi doshavat iva vibhavyate. By moodhas, by ajnanis, taddoshaihi means swapakadi dosha. Shapakadishu vartamanaihi doshaihi. Shapakadinam doshaihi. Brahma doshavat iva vibhavyate. The Brahman also seems to be having doshavat. Vibhavyate. Moodaihi vibhavyate. Is understood by moodhas as having the doshas of shapaka, etc. Tathapi, yet, taddoshaihi asamsprishtam. In reality, Brahman is asamsprishta or asprishta, not touched, not affected by those doshas. Iti nirdosham. Therefore, Brahman is nirdosham. Dosha varjitam. Free from dosha. वै निर्दोषम बिकॉज समम सेम सेम मीन्स फ्री फ्रॉम डिफरेंसेस एंड भाष्यकार एक्सप्लेन्स द समत्व ऑफ ब्रह्मन समत्व मीन्स भेद राहित्य देयर इज नो भेद इन ब्रह्मन नापि
नापि
स्वगुण भेद भिन्नम
स्वगुण भेद भिन्नम
निर्गुणत्वा चैतन्यस्य ब्रह्मन् डस नॉट हैव भेद देन समवन आस्क्स हाउ कैन यू से ब्रह्मन् डस नॉट हैव भेद सी अकॉर्डिंग टू वैशेषिक एंड नैयायिक आत्मा हैज गुण देर आर गुणास इन आत्मा बिकॉज ऑफ द गुणास ऑफ आत्मा देर कैन बी आत्मभेद सो आत्मभेद इज पॉसिबल बिकॉज ऑफ गुणास बट देन द शास्त्र सेज आत्मा इस निर्गुण अशब्दम स्पर्शम रूपम क्रियम तथा रसम नित्यम गंधवच्चयत ऑल गुणास आर नेगेटेड इन दिया सो देयरफॉर वन कैन नॉट से देर इज आत्म भेद बिकॉज ऑफ गुण भेद नापि स्वगुण भेद भिन्नम Brahman is not divided by the differences in its guna. The Atma is not divided by the differences in its gunas. Swaguna bheda bhinnam. Swasya gunaha swagunaha. Swagunanam bhedaha swaguna bhedaha. Taihi bhinnam. Swaguna bheda bhinnam divided by the differences in its guna. It is not possible because chaitanyam is nirguna. Nirgunatvat chaitanyasya. Therefore, guna cannot divide the Brahman because Brahman does not have guna. Generally, gunas divide. All divisions are gunas. All the divisions that we see are because of guna. Nirguna has no divisions. But then, I'm sorry. Vakshyati cha Bhagavan icchadinam. We have read this. Vakshyati cha.
Vakshyati cha.
Bhagavan.
Bhagavan.
Icchadinam.
Icchadinam.
Kshetradharmatvam.
Kshetradharmatvam.
Anadityan nirgunatvat iti cha.
Anadityan nirgunatvat iti cha.
So one Vaisheshika or Nayayika will say, how can you say Atma is nirguna? Because according to his philosophy, Atma has so many gunas. Buddhi, knowledge is a guna of the Atma. Sukha, dukkha are the gunas of the Atma. Iccha, dvesha, prayatna. Iccha, desire. Dvesha, hatred. Prayatna, effort. Atma has so many gunas according to Vaisheshika. But then we tell the Vaisheshika, all that you think are the gunas of the Atma, they do not belong to the Atma. Instead, they belong to the Kshetra. Kshetra means body or mind, Upadhi, Anatma. And in Bhagavad Gita itself, Bhagavan will say, that Ichha, etc., they don't belong to the Atma, they belong to the Kshetra. It is clearly mentioned in Kshetra Kshetrajna Vibhaga Yoga, chapter 13. Ichha dvesha sukham dukham sanghatashchetana dhratihi ityadi. Etat kshetram samasena savikaram udahatam. So there he has told clearly that ichha, etc., they don't belong to the Atma, they belong to Anatma Kshetra. Bhagavan Ichhadinam Kshetra Dharmatvam Vakshati. Bhagavan will mention that Ichha, etc., which are thought to be the gunas of the Atma, Vainayayika, are not Atma Dharma, they are not Kshetrajna Dharma, instead they are Kshetra Dharma. This will be told later in chapter 13. Also, there is another statement, Anadityan Nirgunatvan Iticha. So, Paramatma is Anadi and Nirguna. It is also told in Gita. Therefore, Paramatma or Brahman is free from Guna. Therefore, there is no dividing quality in Brahman. Then Vaisheshika says, according to Vaisheshika, there is something called Vishesha. He accepts a tattva called Vishesha. See, there are seven padarthas according to Nayayika and Vaisheshika. They accept seven padarthas. One such padartha is called Vishesha. Dravya, Guna, Karma, Samanya, Vishesha, Samavaya and Abhava. These are seven padarthas. Among them, one padartha is called Vishesha. It is his idea. We don't have anything called Vishesha in Vedanta. Vishesha is a technical term used by Nayayika. So according to him, certain things which are absolutely similar, two things may be absolutely similar, then there is nothing to make a distinction between them. Then what causes the distinction between them? It is called Vishesha. For example, there are Prithivi Paramanava. Prithivi Paramanu means the atoms of the earth. I am speaking in the language of Nayayika. So according to him, four elements, Prithivi, Jala, Vayu, Agni, these four elements are made of Paramanus. There are four types of Paramanus which make these four types of elements. So Prithivi, Paramanu, there are many Paramanus. One Prithivi Paramanu and another Prithivi Paramanu. What causes the difference between them? He cannot say attributes cause the difference, because attributes are same in both the Prithivi Paramanus. Then how they are different? Then he says there is something called Vishesha. In each Paramanu, there is a Vishesha. The Vishesha is the one which makes one Paramanu different from another Paramanu. That is his explanation. in the Paramanus there are Visheshas. Likewise, he says, in Atma also there are Vishesha. My Atma is different from your Atma. Why? There is a Vishesha in my Atma. What is Vishesha? He will not be able to explain. There is something called Vishesha. That is why my Atma is different from your Atma. So Vishesha is a tattva, a padartha, which distinguishes one from another of the same kind when the attributes are same, when the attributes cannot make a distinction. So that is called Vishesha. It's an idea, a concept of Vishesha. So no, Siddhanti says, Siddhanti is telling the Vaisheshika, there is no pramana for such thing called Vishesha. There is no pramana for such a thing called Vishesha. Napi antyaha visheshaha. So they are called antyaha visheshaha. So antyaha bhedaka, antyaha bhedaka, visheshas are called antyaha bhedaka. They are the final things which distinguish. Means when there is no other thing to distinguish, he accepts vishesha as the antya bhedaka. They are called Visheshaha. They cannot be Atmanaha Bhedakaha. They cannot divide the Atma because Prati Shariram Tesham Sattve Pramana Anupapattehe. Because there is no Pramana for their existence. There is no Pramana to say that the Vishesha exists in every body, Pratishariram, in each body, Tesham Sattve, for their presence, Pramana Anupapattehe, there cannot be any Pramana. So Vishesha cannot be justified, because there is no Pramana to say that there is something called Vishesha. Therefore, there is nothing to divide the Atma. There is nothing to cause Bheda in the Atma. Therefore, he says, Ataha,
Ataha.
Samam Brahma Ekancha Yasmat.
Samam Brahma Ekancha Tas.
Yasmat, right? Yasmat.
Yasmat.
Or Tasmat. Tasmat. Tasmat is a better reading. Tasmat,
tasmat,
Brahmani eva te sthitaha,
Brahmani eva te sthitaha,
Ataha samam Brahma ekancha, Ataha, therefore Brahman is ekam. Ekam means without any, it is one. One means without any division, therefore it is samam, same everywhere. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.